I want everybody to be aware, it's already 15 till 12, so I'm gonna take a little bit extra over that 12, and it'll be all right. Okay, there you go. Yeah, okay, 2 Corinthians chapter 3, if you will. And we started off with this talking about the Apostle Paul and the problems that he was dealing with. And you know, we think back to then, Judaizers, and we think, well, they were the ones that said that it's not grace alone, but they tried to combine grace and the law. And Paul wanted to be very clear to them, the law will not save you. And it's not grace plus the law that saves us. But, you know, it's ironic. We, if we're not careful, will think the same thing. We'll say, okay, I'm saved by faith in Christ alone, but then we'll try to tag on works that everybody has to keep. Well, now you can't go to them R-rated movies, you can't listen to this kind of music, you can't do this, you can't do that. If you're really a Christian, you won't do that. And we do that. We do that. And that is adding a law to grace. Paul wanted them to understand, grace is all the power you need to live the Christian life. You know what? If you fall in love with Jesus, you're not going to want to get drunk. You're not going to watch filthy movies. Because if you're sitting there watching them and they start all that cussing, the Holy Spirit is who is inside of you will grieve your spirit. And you will know, you know what? This is not for me. I got to watch PG movies or at the most, nothing else. And so the grace that saves us is the grace that keeps us. If you're truly saved, you will never lose your salvation. You will never lose it. Because if God moves into you, who's going to kick him out of you?
Only you.
Jesus said, I hold them in my hand. No one can pluck them from the Father's hand. Now, does it mean I'll be a perfect Christian? Oh, no. You ask Lenita if you think that. She'll straighten you out on my Christianity. I think that's part of a wife's duty is to let her husband know his shortcomings. I've certainly got them. Okay, so let's look on down there. Verse 1 of 2 Corinthians 3. Are we beginning to commend ourselves again? Or do we need as some letters of commendation to you or from you? You are our letter, written in our hearts, known and read by all men, being manifest that you are a letter of Christ, cared for by us, written not with ink, but with the Spirit of the living God, not on the tablets of stone, but on the tablets of the human heart. You know what? Those laws that were written on the stone, that God had Moses come up and he wrote them on the stones. Moses couldn't even get down until they had already broken all of them. And you know, before he went up, they said, oh yes, we'll keep them all, we'll do them all. But it's just like us. Our spirit wants to, but our flesh sometimes don't want to. And there's a war that goes on between the spirit and the flesh. And who wins? The one you feed the most. If you feed the spirit, that's what we talk about. Listen to Christian radio. Read your Bible. Spend time in prayer. That is your food. That's what keeps you strong. That's what enables you to stand. Just like Jesus, when he fought Satan, what did he use? The Word of God. That's all he needed to shut Satan's mouth. It's all we need too. The Word of God. So then it goes on as he's talking. He says, such confidence we have through Christ towards God. Verse 5. Not that we are adequate in ourselves to consider anything as coming from ourselves, but our adequacy is from God. Now listen, there's nothing good in us except God. So the part of us that wants to serve God with our flesh God says, die to your flesh. Die to your flesh. So the Spirit can live through you and enable you to do what He wants to do. It's not the best of my love. It's letting God's love live through me. You know, if we clicked over to Galatians, and we won't, but grace, mercy, love, compassion, all of those are not fruits that we have. Those are fruits of the Holy Spirit. And when we say, Lord, I can't do this, I need you to do it, what does God do? That faith unleashes the Holy Spirit to turn the other cheek, to go the extra mile, to forgive when somebody cuts you off in traffic. It can only be done by God. But you have God in you. And all you have to do is let God live through you. So when you come upon different situations in the week, and you know you can't do it, you just got to say a little short prayer. Lord, I can't do it. You do it. And will He answer that prayer?
No, He will.
Every time He will answer that prayer. So here He says, I understand I'm not adequate in and of myself, but the Holy Spirit is my adequacy. Verse 7. But if the ministry of death in letters engraved on stones came with glory, so that the sons of Israel could not look intently at the face of Moses, because of the glory of his face fading as it was, how will the ministry of the Spirit fail to be even more with glory? So what is he talking about there? He's saying, you know what? The stones that had the Ten Commandments on it, if they came with glory, and that was a ministry of death. Now, wait a minute. Why were the stones a ministry of death? Because we were all convicted by the Ten Commandments. God said, if you fail in one commandment, what? You failed in it all. Brothers and sisters, we all failed the test. You know, didn't you like to hear that in school when the whole classroom failed the test? Amen. I'm not alone. We all failed the test. But you know what? When it comes to salvation, we all failed the test. But the good news is Jesus took the test for us.
Amen.
He made 100. And He makes the great exchange. Sonny, you take my test grade, I'll take your test grade. Hey, man, I'll do that, Lord, because I could never be good enough. None of us are going to deserve heaven. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
You know what? None of us are adequate in and of ourselves. When we get to heaven and they say, why should I let you in? What are you going to say? Because of Jesus, He paid it all. He made a way where there was no way. That faith, same faith that Abraham had. How was Abraham saved? By faith. We're saved by faith. What is faith? Faith is just like this. Do I think this chair can hold me up? I think so. Do I know this chair will hold me up? Place yourself in it. That's what we do with God. We say, God, I can't save myself. I can't be good enough. But I have faith. I know you were good enough. And I know the great exchange that we can make. My score for your score. And brothers and sisters, that is going to be a shouting day when we get to heaven. We're a little intimidated down here to make too much noise. But I guarantee you, when we get up there, we're going to be shouting hallelujahs to the Lord.
Amen.
Because we didn't deserve it. But Jesus paid it all.
Amen.
All to Him I owe. Sin. Sin had left a crimson stain. But Jesus, He washed it white as snow. It says, to Him who is able to present you and you and you and you faultless before the throne of God. You're going to be presented with no sin, no reference to sin. That's the only way we can go in the presence of God. God can't tolerate any sin. So we have to be perfect. And that position in Christ never changes. Now our condition daily changes. Daily I sin. Daily I have to ask God to forgive me. But my position, I'm a son of the living God, placed in Christ. That will never change. Isn't that good news? That's good news we can go out the door with today, because we know Jesus made a way for us where there wasn't any way. Saved by grace through faith. And that's not even of yourselves. God gives us the faith to believe in what he did for us. Let's pray together. Father, thank you for your wonderful word. Oh, Lord, I know that our flesh wants to try and try and try. But Lord, teach us to die, to die, to die to our flesh. And have faith in you to do the things you want to do through each one of our lives. And Lord, we thank you for that blessed day when you called our name. And we heard you. And we came to you. And Lord, perhaps today you're walking amongst us. And you're calling someone's name. Lord, give them the faith to step out of that pew and come to the front to receive you as their Lord and Savior. Father, it says these things are written that you may know you have eternal life. It's not a guessing game. When you paid it all we have to do is believe and receive all that you've done. And Father, we will give you the praise and glory, for it's in Jesus' wonderful name that we pray. Amen. Let's stand. Sing a hymn of invitation.
305. 305. 305. Oh, I'm a